Hi, I'm Samir from Samsung. Bada phones are available with range of screen resolutions, and to make sure your UI looks is best on all of them, Bada 2.0 makes it easier for you to develop a scalable UI for your app. In this video, we will show you how to create a scalable UI with some techniques to ensure your app looks is best on all Bada devices. Here is the app we'll be using to show you how to implement a scalable UI. The dialer simplifies the process of making an international call. We combine the service provider's number with the destination number to make an international call. You can enter number directly or choose from one of your contacts.
Please enter the number you would like to call.
We are going to use this app to show you three techniques for creating a resolution independent UI. First, we will explain you how to create a different versions of your form for all supported resolutions. Then we will introduce the relative layout feature and auto scaling. Finally, we will show you how to create the form programmatically using the new logical coordinate feature. To put the finishing touches to your UI, we will explain you how to create images for different resolutions. Bada 2.0 currently supports devices with resolutions of 480x800, 320x480, and 240x400. One approach we can use to support all these devices is to create separate forms optimized for each resolution. The form matching the resolution of the device will then be loaded by platform on runtime. Make sure that auto-scaling is turned off when you are using separate form for different resolutions, since it will be turned on by default when you create your project. You can find these settings in Project Properties, Bada Build, Application Information. Don't worry, we will explain how the auto-scaling feature works later in this video. Once you have created your form for one resolution, creating further versions is easy. In the IDs resource editor, choose your form, then select Generate menu item. From the Generate resource file dialog, choose the additional resolutions for which you want to create resource and then click Finish. The form will be created at the requested resolutions. Here is the dialer app running on different resolution screens. The correct version of our form is chosen by platform at runtime. Creating separate forms for each screen resolution works well, but Bada 2.0 introduces some more powerful techniques. Another approach to support multiple screen resolutions is to create a single form and use the relative layout style introduced in Bada 2.0. We will add the controls relative to each other or the form so that the controls will be adjusted automatically for the screen resolutions. To use this method of UI scaling, you need to ensure that auto scaling is on and that the base resolution is specified. By default, this will be normal size, which is 480x800 WVGA screen. We create our form for 480x800 and let the platform take care of scaling the size and the placement of the controls when our app runs on other resolution devices. Let's have a look at our app running in different resolutions with the form created using relative layout style. With both of these resource-based approaches, it's very easy to support new devices and there is no need to change the code. You can also support multiple device resolutions by creating your form and its control programmatically and using the logical coordinate system introduced in Bada 2.0. In the logical coordinate system, every device is assumed to have fixed width of 480 pixels. If auto-scaling is enabled in the project preferences, then all drawing uses these logical coordinates and is scaled using base resolution. By default, this base resolution is normal size, that is 480x800. The physical resolution of WQVGA screen is 240x400, but its logical resolution is 480x800. An HVGA screen has a physical resolution of 320x480, but has a logical resolution of 480x720 to allow the platform to maintain the aspect ratio when scaling. In your code, you should use API, get bounds, or get client area bounds to position your controls relative to the form rather than using hard-coded values. Now let's add one more feature to the app. We will add new buttons to access new features. While this button will fit within the coordinates of WVGA and WQVGA devices, which have the height of 800 pixels in the logical coordinate system, there won't be room at the bottom of the form on the HVGA device. One way to solve this problem is troll panel, the height of which we will set relative to the height of the form. We will keep the same dimensions and position of all the controls and add them to the scroll panel. This code is written for 480 by 800 screen resolution, but still this is working fine on devices with all the three different resolutions. This is because we have considered the screen height when creating the scroll panel, and on HVGA devices, the form scrolls to reveal the extra buttons. It is recommended that you don't use deprecated APIs and UI elements such as soft key, option key, and list in your app. This will make sure that your app will run seamlessly with future releases of bada. We have talked about supporting different screen resolutions, but there is another factor to consider, screen density. Bada 2.0 supports three screen values for different densities, high, middle, and low, from the low dots per inch of the Wave 525 series to the high DPI of the Wave 1, 2, and 3 devices. You need to design your app's images with the screen density in mind. You can create optimized images of different qualities and place them in screen density low, middle, or high under resource folder. The correct images will be chosen based on the pixel density of the device. In this video, we showed you various techniques introduced in Bada 2.0 for supporting different screen resolutions. We explained how to create different form for different screen resolution screens and went through code in our dialer app to create complex form programmatically. Finally, we showed you how to take account of screen density when designing your app images. All these features will help you to keep your app's UI looking great on Bada devices. To find out sample code used in this video and other related content, please visit developer.bada.com. Thanks for watching.